in full glory reflected, now shines in the stream. 'Tis the star-spangled banner, O long made wave, the land of the free and the home of the brave. Where is that band who so vaunted is worth the half of the war and the boundless conversion, a home and a country would leave us no more? Their blood has washed out their foul footsteps pollution. No refuge could save hireling or slave from the terror of fight or the gloom of the grave and the star-spangled banner in triumph of blood for the land of the free and the home of the brave. When free men shall stand between their loved homes and the war's desolation, blessed with victory and peace, may the heaven-rescued land praise the Lord that made and preserved us. Let conquer we must, when our cause it is just. And this be our motto: in God is our trust. In the star-spangled banner, in triumph, shall wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Brother-in-laws here in the city, who had lately been a lieutenant commander here at Fort McHenry, Joseph Nicholson. And I showed Nicholson my poem, and he was so impressed by it that he insisted that we take it to the offices of a local newspaper and have it struck off. And it was printed in handbills and distributed throughout the city, and within a few days, the poem, which I entitled The Defense of Fort McHenry, was being printed in newspapers up and down the Atlantic coast. By Christmas of 1814, it had been retitled The Star-Spangled Banner and had been set to a very popular tune of the day known as To an Apriana in Heaven. And from that point, my poem, the song, The Star-Spangled Banner, gained increasing respect among the people of our nation, for which I am most grateful. I'm occasionally asked, have I ever received any remuneration for having written the words to that poem? And I can, in all honesty, say that I have not received one penny for the efforts that I made in September of 1814. But what I have received is more important than any monetary amount could ever be, and that is that I have been blessed with the respect and the regard of my fellow Americans from that day to this. And I thank all of you for coming here today and for allowing me to speak before you. And I hope that you have enjoyed everything that you have experienced here today, including Ranger Paul's talk. And thank you all for being with us today.